Y'all stand up, please. Let's open up with a word of prayer. Our Heavenly Father, as we come before your throne of grace today, we're so grateful for the blessings of life. We're so grateful, Lord, that you lead us and guide us. We thank you for those that have come to celebrate the homecoming of Mr. Don. We pray, God, that you be with his service, that you would use it and you would bless it. And Lord, we just love you and thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I think we got some music to start with.
Getting dark to see. it's quite an honor to be asked to do a eulogy for someone. And Kelly, thank you. My name is Roger. I'm married to Carol, Don's oldest sister. I didn't know Don as a youngster. When I started dating Carol 25 years ago, I came to know Don along with the other brothers and family. And Don was the youngest of five siblings. He was the baby of the family. He had a few quirks, most of you probably know. If I had to hang a title on him, it would be he's the world's pickiest eater. And Carol would be right behind him. At one point, we owned a condo in North Myrtle Beach, and we took Don with us one time down to just enjoy a getaway, and our custom was to take food with us so that we wouldn't have to go shopping and we could just enjoy the beach and relax. And on the way down, we found out Don had a bad foot injury and he was limping everywhere he went. Before we retired that night, we told them we were going to sleep in the next morning. Here's a key. Feel free to leave, go down and enjoy the beach if you get up before we do. And late the next morning, we got up and we discovered Don had risen and looked in the refrigerator, didn't like what we had, and had limped all the way up to the grocery store, a quarter mile away to buy his own food, and limped all the way back and prepared a breakfast on sausage and eggs for all of us. So. This early illustration of his willingness to do whatever to satisfy his own food tastes speaks a lot about his character. Well, Carol and I had the honor of being witnesses when Don and Kelly got married, along with Sue and her son Daniel. So we were there pretty much from the start of that marriage, and from a distance, we watched what was going on, aided by phone calls between brother and sister. And through that, we became familiar with the difficulties that Don and Kelly faced in raising someone with particular needs. I know it was hard, and I know it still is. I developed an admiration for Don, seeing how he took on such a responsibility. Even though he had no experience with raising a child, especially someone with special needs, his love and commitment to Kelly and Daniel was evident. And we watched him grow as both husband and parent. Don never retreated. He never shied away from the marriage commitment that he made. His life was a triumph of the hardship. And from our perspective, the decade that he and Kelly were married were the best years of Don's life. In his recent years, Don developed a lot of medical problems, severe health issues. His lungs started giving out, limiting his ability to work and enjoy life. In addition to his scarred lungs, he was diagnosed with a severe blockage of the main artery of his heart, and this necessitated open heart surgery for a double bypass, and the surgery was successful, and following that, he was placed in the ICU at Duke Hospital, and where he bravely fought to regain his health and his strength, and he spent the better part of a month in that ICU, and at times he was in some really deep difficulty. He gasped for breath around the clock, and it had to be torturous at times. During our frequent visits to see him in the ICU, we watched him labor in breathing. And frequently he would suffer anxiety attacks. I don't know how many of you might have had anxiety attacks, but that's an awful thing to experience. At one point, he stopped breathing altogether. And the staff of the ICU really made their money, earned their pay that night. Don was in there for Kelly's birthday. Don was in the ICU for Easter. It was a tough 4 weeks. Van Penny, Don's cousin, put an encouraging post on Facebook that struck me. Van said, "Don is a penny." So he's tough as nails. He will not let this keep him down. And we have to agree, Don never stopped fighting. He was generous and giving to the end, and he took special pride that his eyes would be donated so that somebody else could see, and his skin would be donated for burn victims in the burn unit. So what a blessing that is for those recipients. On the spiritual side, Don confided to Carol once that when he was 14, in the church, he responded to an altar call and walked down the aisle of that church and prayed forgiveness for his sins and invited Christ into his life. While he was in the ICU after one of those particularly bad episodes of a near-death experience, he requested a visit from the Duke Chaplain. And then on the day before he died, Pastor Ray Rogers visited him in the ICU and witnessed to him and discussed Don's salvation with him. And Don peacefully assured Pastor Rogers that he was indeed ready. I'm not much of a Facebook person, but over the period of time that Don was in the ICU, there's been an impressive number of Facebook posts of encouragement. There's been an overwhelming number of people that have prayed for Don and a miracle. In the end, God answered those prayers. We can only imagine how wonderful it is for Don today. No more struggle, no more difficulties, no more health issues. Just joyous peace. He's got a perfect body, perfect mind, perfect spirit. He is in eternity in heaven. His life was one of triumph, one of overcoming. He was an encourager. He was a peacemaker. And he'll be sorely missed. All of us have the same opportunity that Don had for our own salvation. And Don is waiting.
Thank you.
Mr. Roger is, I'm grateful and honored to be able to be here today and share this funeral with y'all. It's always sad when we lose somebody, that separation is probably the hardest thing. You know, you're not going to ever see them again until you leave here. But Don assured me that day that I visited him that he was ready to go to heaven. He was looking forward to it. And as I sit there and watch Mr. Don that day, he was more concerned with the people around him than he was his own self. He kept telling them, you're going to be all right. You're going to be all right. He had peace. And that kind of peace only comes from God. We can't get it nowhere else. But as we look today, we look at Mr. Don. He was 62 years old. He passed away Wednesday, April 20th, at Duke University Medical Center. Don was born on November 3rd, 1959, in Harnett County, North Carolina, to the late Hubert Rayford and Mary Edna Katz Penny. He was also preceded in death by his brothers Danny Ray Penny and Rayford Earl Penny. Mr. Penny was a contract dump truck driver. He loved fishing, he loved his dogs, and he loved his family. Now that's a combination. But that was the type of person he was. He just impressed me. I didn't ever talk to him but one time. But Mr. Don impressed me. It wasn't like other visits I've had with other people. There was just something special about him. The love he had for his family and the concern he had for those that he was leaving behind. Surviving included his wife of 10 years, Miss Kelly Taylor Penny, his son Daniel Sears, sisters Carol Holden, husband Roger, Connie Barr, husband Frank, sister-in-law Emily Penny, and his special dog named Maverick. He also had many loving nieces and nephews. So I would imagine Mr. Don had a pretty good life up till he got sick. But the Word of God, it tells us in John 14, chapter 14, verse 1, it says, let my heart be troubled. If you believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. And if it were not so, I would have told you. He said, I go and prepare a place for you. So God had prepared a place for Mr. Don because God knows everything that's taking place in our lives. He knows your sicknesses. He knows your trials. He knows your ups and downs. There's nothing that he does not know that's going on in your life. We can hide nothing. So he had prepared a place for Mr. Don, and Mr. Don was looking forward to it. Looking forward to it. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And where I go, you know, and the way. You know. See, Don knew all this. He knew that he wasn't going to be healed here on earth. There's two healings. We can be healed here, or we can be healed there. That's the ultimate healing in heaven. And my prayer today is each and every one of you are ready. In here today are ready for heaven. And if you're not, you need to get ready. Because you'll be separated from loved ones and friends and family for eternity if you're not. God said you must be born again to receive that gift of eternal life. He says, it says in Psalms 23, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters, and he restores my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Well, Mr. Don just got through walking through his valley, and God gave him peace. I would say he's a winner. I would say he's a winner. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. God never leaves us, family, friends. God never leaves us. He's always with us. He tells us in his word that he'll never leave us or forsake us. He tells us in his word that we need to ask and it shall be given. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies.
You anoint my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I'm sure standing here today and looking at y'all, Mr. Doms, thinking and hoping that each one of you are ready for that gift of eternal life. That you'll see him once again, because if you're not, you won't see him. That's the only way you're going to get to see him again. I not only came to preach Mr. Don's funeral, but I came to share with family and friends too. Don has made it to his ultimate victory. He is celebrating with the Lord Jesus Christ today. No more pain, no more heartache, no more tears. He'll never go through that again. He's rejoicing with the Lord Jesus Christ. And if you're in here today and you're not ready, you need to get ready. You need to get ready. Living this time, living the life out here in the world is not what you need. The Lord Jesus Christ is what you need. Jesus also said, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. You believe in him, you'll never die. You'll live right on and right on and right on. And everyone who lives and believes in me shall never die. John 10:27 says, my sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. I give them eternal life, and they will never perish. And no one will snatch them out of my hand. My Father, who has given them to me, is greater than all, and no one is able to snatch them out of the Father's hand. My sheep hear my voice. When it's time for you to be saved, you're going to be wooed by the Holy Spirit of God, and it's going to convict you to the point where you're going to have to do something. You will have to do something. And my prayer today also is that the Holy Spirit will convict those out here that aren't saved and aren't ready to make that trip to heaven. I pray that he'll convict you so bad that you'll make that decision. Because without it, you're going to go to a devil's hell, and you're going to be part of that for eternity. Ecclesiastes 3 says, there's a time for everything. There's a season for every activity under heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to uproot. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to tear down and a time to rebuild. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. In the next few days, some are going to realize this separation from Don more than others. Miss Kelly, it's going to be hard. Separating and not being able to wake up with him beside you. And there's just things that are going to take place. But God is there for you. He's there to protect you. He's there to comfort you. You pray. You ask for strength. You ask for wisdom. And he'll give it to you. He will comfort you and Daniel in these days ahead, the whole family. That's what God does. He comforts us and he takes care of us in these times. And you have to look to him and you have to ask for that help, because it's going to be hard separating yourself from each other, because you know until you make that eternal trip, you're not going to see him again. But he's waiting on you. And he's going to be there overlooking you, making sure you're okay. God is our refuge. God is our peacemaker. God is our strength. God is everything in the world that we need. The world has nothing to offer us but bad, disasters, heartbreak. That's why we need the Lord so bad. I pray that in the days ahead you'll seek God's wisdom. I pray that you'll pray and ask God to help you. And if any of you are lost and need Christ, I pray that you'll ask him into your heart. It's just that simple. You ask for forgiveness and you ask to receive. You have to believe and receive. It's that simple. But in the days ahead, you're going to need comfort from family. You're gonna need to talk to your family. You're gonna need that strength that you can draw from your family and God. And I pray that y'all pull together in the next few weeks and comfort one another. And days ahead, Miss Kelly, you're gonna be okay. You're gonna be okay. Don knew it. He knew it. He knew that you were gonna be taken care of. And I can also say that Don was a man of his word. If he told you something, he tried to do it. He tried to do it. And there was things as he lay there in that bed and I listened to him, there was things that he had promised people he was going to do. And he was trying to get all that together and see who was going to be first as he got it taken care of. Now, family, that's a man of God. That's a man that loves his family. And if he wants the best for you here, don't you know that he wants the best for you in heaven? He wants you to be ready to make that trip because we never know when our last day is on this earth. Let's pray, Father. We're so thankful that we could gather here for this homeboy of Mr. Don. We know that it's going to be hard. We know there's going to be times of lowness and times of heartbreaking, times of tears, and that's okay. That's what we do. But God, I pray that each one of them here today will trust in you, turn to you, and let you do the work that needs to be done. I thank you for the family. I pray that your blessing would be upon them. Lord, that you would lead them and guide them, give them strength and wisdom. And Father, most of all, I pray that they lean on you. Touch this family. Bless these friends. And God, just do the work that you need to do here. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Back if you want to meet with them and talk to them. They'll be right in this room right here.
Blessed afternoon.